willing to, then they can, but I don't think it's something that should be pressured at this moment.
Well, you're the drive time audience. Do you still give to charity? Do let me know. 80295 is the text. Do you still give to charity? 80295. Also tonight.
I need somebody to hear, somebody to know, somebody to have, somebody to hold.
It's Lewis Capaldi, he is now, I think, the number one song all time in terms of downloads. So we'll have a chat about all that. So, but fundamentally, are we too poor to be kind? 80295, do you still give to charity? Do let me know. It's 4:30.
On digital radio.
FM.
Your smart speaker.
And online.
BBC Radio Scotland.
It's time for news and sport for the Borders with David Knox. Good afternoon. The two elderly people from Kelso who were killed on Friday in a crash near Lauder have been named by the police. 79-year-old Adam Allan and Christine Allan, who was 85, were in a red Kia Venga when it collided with a blue Kia Sportage on the A697 Carfrey Mill to Greenlaw Road at around 4:30 p.m. The female driver of the Sportage was taken to Edinburgh Royal Infirmary for treatment. A 72-year-old woman also died on Friday in a separate crash on the Kelso to Smalham Road at around 9 a.m. Anyone who witnessed either crash is asked to contact police on 101. A 32-year-old man from Selkirk has appeared in private at the town's sheriff court accused of rape. Adam Wood also faces two charges of sexual assault. He made no plea and the case was continued for further examination. He was released on bail. The Hawick woman has also appeared in private at Selkirk Sheriff Court charged with assault to severe injury and permanent disfigurement. 56-year-old Beverly Lyons made no plea and the case was continued for further examination. She was also granted bail. No date has yet been given for her next court appearance. An appeal has been made following the latest break-in at a Borders farm. A £4,000 Honda quad bike was taken during the raid at a farm just outside Kelso on Saturday night into Sunday morning. Police are also appealing for help in tracing who was responsible for setting fire to the male toilets at the Common Hawk car park in Hawick earlier this month. Repairs are being done to the floor and walls following the blaze on Tuesday, November the 1st. Former rugby league player Kevin Sinfield has reached Otterburn on the second leg of his Seven Ultras in 7 Days challenge to raise money for MND charities. Inspired by his friend and former teammate Rob Burrows and by Doddy Weir, he is running nearly 40 miles each day. The former Leeds Rhino left Murrayfield yesterday morning, reaching the Green Yards in the afternoon. Today left Melrose early this morning before passing through Ancram and Jedburgh en route to Otterburn and ultimately to the men's Rugby League World Cup final at Old Trafford on Saturday. Kevin, who's almost a third of the way to his cash target of just under £800,000, spoke to BBC's Breakfast before leaving the Green Yards just before 7 a.m.
How are you feeling this morning? How did you sleep?
Yeah, I slept really well. I think there was a warthog in my room last night, so...
Does the warthog have a name?
I don't think it's fair to disclose live on TV, but no, it's good coming here. We had a really good day yesterday. People in Melrose came out to see us, and you know, last night, you know, we did as expected. We got together as a team and ate together and enjoyed some time together. So we're all ready to go now.
Tributes have been paid to former Scotland rugby team doctor Donald MacLeod. Donald, who is also president of the SRU for a spell, died yesterday at the age of 81. During a distinguished medical career, the resident of the Ettrick Valley was also doctor for the British and Irish Lions tour of New Zealand in 1983. A stalwart of Selkirk Rugby Club, the flag will fly at half-mast this week at Philip Hawk, and there'll be a minute's silence ahead of the weekend's derby with Jed Forrest. Well, turning to sport now, and there was defeat for Scotland at Murrayfield yesterday as the wait for a first win over New Zealand goes on. Well, despite Scotland leading for most of the match, a late try was enough to win it for the All Blacks. In local rugby, the big Borders derby, Hawick made it 10 games unbeaten this season with a 26-7 win over Jed Forrest, scoring a 4-try bonus point and staying top of the table. The bonus point try came from a delighted prop, Sean Muir.
Hi, I know I've not scored many this season. I got my second, but that'll look at the bigger pictures, the squad, the 5 points for us, that was the most important thing. Didn't matter who scored it as long as we got it. Frustrating until the last minute, very scrappy. Fair play to Jed, they stuck in, put us under a lot of pressure, but we ground it out and we got the 5 points, which is massive at this stage of the season.
Well, also in the Premiership, Selkirk remain unbeaten on the road with a 29-19 win at Glasgow Hawks. In National One, top of the table, Kelso saw off Watsonians 31-15. Gallant destroyed Stirling County 55-17 and Melrose won 36-30 at Highland. In National League Two, Peebles went down 28-22 to Falkirk, while Berwick lost 27-12 against Dumfries. In football's Lowland League, Galloferradine Rovers were defeated 3-2 at home to Stirling University, despite fighting back from being 3-0 down. Berwick Rangers, though, lost 5-0 up at East Kilbride. In these conferences, Vale of Leithen lost 3-1 away to Crossgates Primrose, while Coldstream also lost 1-0 to Kennaway Star. Peebles Rovers emerged victorious with a 3-0 victory against Ormiston Primrose, and Tweedmouth Rangers also picked up the win as they beat Newborough Juniors 2-1. And the honours were even between the two Alberts. Ali Crowell Albert drawing 4-all with Lockelly Albert. An 8-goal thriller indeed. Time for the Borders weather. Here's Gillian Smart.
This evening and tonight will remain largely dull and cloudy with mist in places. Overnight there'll be some drizzle under the thickest cloud. A few clear breaks may develop. Lows of 6 to 9 Celsius tonight. Tomorrow morning we'll start with some sunny spells, but thickening cloud will soon build in from the west and it will bring spells of heavy, blustery rain that will linger for the rest of the day. It'll be breezy with highs of 8 to 11 Celsius. BBC Radio Scotland weather for the Borders.
Want, just say, play BBC News for Scotland.
You're listening to Drive Time on BBC Radio Scotland. To Ukraine now, where residents in the city of Kherson have continued to celebrate the departure of Russian troops. The authorities there, though, are warning supplies of bread and medicine have run out.